The next topic that we're trying to cover today is we'll do a very comprehensive SWOT analysis. Now, SWOT analysis from a case study perspective, whether it is operational, management or strategic, is the backbone for your examination. If you are able to do a very comprehensive SWOT analysis, questions are likely that either the weakness might be picked up as a question or the opportunity or the threat. So let us look at how do we do a SWOT analysis, though it's simple, but there are certain points that we need to keep in mind. So a SWOT analysis is basically divided into four sections. So we have strength, we have weakness, we have opportunities, and we have threats. Now we need to keep in mind that strengths or weakness are the as-is elements of any organization. So they are current, they are relevant only to the organization. So they are not influenced by the market, they are not influenced by the competitors, but yes, they are related only to an organization, both in terms of current strengths and current weakness. So strengths for an organization becomes their unique selling proposition, which is what earns them business in the short run. And weakness, if you look at, are generally the risks which are relevant to an organization from a short term to a medium term perspective. So for every weakness that an organization has, they need to have a corresponding mitigation plan in place. Now the intent would be that if you kind of mitigate a weakness, it will become a strength in the current, or it might give you the lever to exploit an opportunity in the future. So when you look at strengths and weakness, it has to be the as is and it has to be related to the organization. Now many a time student gets confused whether it is a strength, whether it is an opportunity, or where does it get plotted on the SWOT analysis. So there are three questions that if you answer will give you this, remove this doubt. So first is, what is the impact of the strength, weakness, opportunity or the threat in the short term, in the medium term and in the long term? So by kind of plotting the strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats onto SWOT, if you keep in mind these set of questions, that will help you plot them in the right quadrant. So when I look at the short term element, I'm basically talking about whether it has an impact on the profit or the for the organization. When I look at the medium term, I'm basically looking at the wealth maximization for the shareholders. And when I look at the long term component, I'm basically looking at the competitive advantage for the organization over its competitors. So whatever is a strength, whatever is a weakness or the opportunity threat, the calibration has to be around these three elements from a short term, from a medium term and from a long term perspective. Now when we look at opportunities and when we look at threats, so these would be opportunities available to an organization basis the market. So new products coming into the market, new technology coming into the market, new tastes and preferences evolving of the customer. So that is what has the impact of market. The second would be in terms of competitors. So competitors adopting new strategies, competitors adopting new marketing strategies, all of that also impacts the opportunities and threats for an organization. It could be organizations focus on improving its efficiency, improving its effectiveness, and improving the economy. So these could also be classified as opportunities or threats. It could also be basis the future vision of the organization or any changing goals of an organization. So while the first section, the strengths and weaknesses, are only related to the organization, this is related to different factors: the market, the competitors. So market includes customers, competitors. Organizations drive around effectiveness, efficiency and economy, and also the way in which they want to achieve their vision and the goals. Now threats, if you look at, these are also risks for an organization, but they are primarily in the medium term to long term. Right? Now when we prepare a SWOT analysis for an organization, when through a case study, so you get your briefing well in advance, so there will be certain elements which will be implicit in the case study, and there will be certain elements which will be explicit in the case study. Now explicit elements in the case studies are no-brainer, and that is something that everybody can do. The important element is to be able to interpret and decipher implicit elements of our case study, which then get plotted as strengths, weakness, opportunities and threats. Now for any pre-seen case study at any level, we do not recommend that you directly start preparing a SWOT. Before you prepare a SWOT, there are different analyses that need to be done, and I'll give you a list of recommended analyses that will help you prepare a very comprehensive SWOT. The first being the PESTEL analysis. So if you do a PESTEL analysis, you will get a lot of inputs. So that is where you do an implicit interpretation of data given in the case study. The second is we also make use of the five forces, the Porter's five forces. So that will give you insights from an opportunity threat perspective relating to the market. It will also tell you the strengths and weakness of the organization. The third element that we need to look at is the FSA, which is the financial statement analysis. Now, many a times when you do a SWOT analysis, people, candidates, even sometimes invigilators forget to kind of bring in the financial statement analysis element into your SWOT. Now, there could be that a company has a very low gearing ratio, and tomorrow if you want to go in for an expansion, you have that capacity to borrow more. Now, that becomes an opportunity for an organization. Now, today if my current ratio or the interest service coverage ratio is high, and tomorrow I want to incur more marketing expenses, or maybe my cost increases because I take more loans, that will put pressure on profits. But let's say my interest service coverage ratio is about 8 times to profit at this point in time, and if I borrow more, then it might go down to 6. But 6 and 8, both are healthy as compared to their competitors. So financial statement analysis and insights from financial statement analysis also help you get directional input for strengths, weakness, opportunity and threats. And that is what can also be used when you give recommendations to proposals such as capital expansion, setting up offices in new countries. The next is we need to look at the risk analysis. Now, sometimes case studies give you explicit list of all the risks, but they still may not be very comprehensive. So if you understand and interpret all the risks that an organization faces in the short term, medium term and long term, risk analysis will get, so any risk that you have will either get plotted as a weakness or will get plotted as a threat. But the good part is, if you do a risk analysis, we also recommend that you start doing a mitigation plan for every risk. Now, assume a scenario that in your examination, you get a question which is from a threat. Now, we interpreted threats well in advance, and for every threat, we've also plotted a mitigation plan. Now, if we have these two data points ready, and the question, the time limit for writing an answer to the question is about 30 minutes, so you don't have to invest time in thinking. You already know that for this particular risk, this is the mitigation plan. You follow a particular structure and just put then those thoughts in the form of an answer. So that kind of saves time for you. So that is what we look at when we say that we need to do a risk analysis. So PESTEL framework, the five forces, the financial statement analysis and the risk analysis. So if you do all of these components, that is when you will get more thoughts around these four different components in your SWOT analysis. So a very comprehensive SWOT can also give you insights in terms of what are the questions that you can expect. And trust me, the SWOT analysis that we've done in the past for different case studies across levels for different months like the February, the August or the November, there are questions which have come in directly from threats, there are questions that have come in directly from opportunities, and candidates have found it very easy because they were well prepared in terms of a mitigation plan and they were well prepared in terms of the structure that we give to candidates to write answers to the question. So if you follow the right structure, if you do a detailed SWOT analysis and a comprehensive SWOT analysis, you actually save a lot of time from your examination perspective by proactively identifying questions and preparing answers for this. So I hope the SWOT analysis makes sense. There is no shortcut to doing a SWOT analysis. Please follow this approach diligently, do every step, and that is when you will have a very final comprehensive SWOT output. Thank you so much.